And today I'm going to teach you the guitar. So in the first class, we are just going to cover some basic points and two most important exercises that help me to speed up my guitar playing. So, you know, just take out your guitar and we'll start the lesson. Come on. So first thing, we are going to look at the parts of the guitar. So here you can see there are six tuning keys over here, three on the top and three on the bottom. It is corresponding to each string over here. There are six strings, by the way. So each string is attached to one tuning key over here on the left side. So let's name our these strings, and there is a number system also. So we are just going to memorize the numbers of the strings and the name as well. Okay, so the first string is from the bottom. Well, while you are looking at the guitar, you might see this string, but this is the last string. So from the bottom, we will count the first string. First string is called E, second string B, then the third string G, fourth string D, fifth string A, sixth string is E. Okay. So now you know what is tuning keys and the string names and the numbers. So one more thing, these are the tuning keys. Each string has been attached to one tuning key. So before you start playing, always make sure that the guitar is on tune. Okay, if your guitar is not on tune, no matter what you play, it will sound very bad because it's not on tune. So you can use one application, it is called Guitar Tuner. It's available on the Play Store and you can install it, and you can just see the string names which you have already learned. You can see the string names corresponding to the, you know, on the application, and then you can tune it accordingly. Okay, it will tell you how much you need to tighten and loosen the strings. Now we are going to look at the most important concept of guitar. It is these frets over here. Okay, these lines are called frets. And you know, this whole collection of frets is called a fretboard. So we are going to start from here. Can you see the, you know, the space between these frets here? Here the space is more, and when you gradually come to the right hand side of the fretboard, that time the space is decreasing. So that means the notes are going higher and higher. Okay, suppose if I play here. Okay, you saw that when I was playing here, the tone is low, I mean the pitch is low, and when you reach here, it's very high. So that's how it goes. So the low notes are arranged at the left hand side of the guitar. Okay, and the right hand side, as you go to the right hand side of the fretboard, you are going to find the notes which are higher and higher. Okay, so these frets are called as you know, it can be called as a box also, and you can name it as fret number. So this box over here, this whole box is called fret number 1 or box number 1. Okay, so this is box number 2, fret number 2. Like that we will go throughout the guitar, and when we reach the 12th fret, you will find two dots over here. Okay, the same two dots you will be able to see here also. Most of the guitars will have this dot also over here and here also. So this is just like a, you know, marking that when you are playing from here. Okay, so when you are playing from here, you might not see the 12th fret where you are. Okay, so this might help you to locate the 12th fret, and you will be able to play accordingly. So from here, actually the 12th fret, the frets are repeating. Okay, so one note is over here on the 6th string, it is called F. So this note will be after 12th fret, it will start again. The guitar fretboard will start again. So this will also be the first fret after the 12th fret. So from here, it is repeating. So guitar is actually divided into two parts. This is very crucial thing from the point I came to know that from here the fretboard is, you know, repeating. It just changed my way of looking at the guitar. Okay, so you should be knowing these things. You can just look at the frets like keys on the piano. If you press one key on the piano, you will be getting another sound. So here, each fret, each string, I repeat, each fret, each string, you are going to get another sound or a new note. Okay, so suppose we want to locate a note on the guitar. Now how will we locate? I will just tell you the fret number and the string number. So easy, just the fret number and the string number. So let me tell you the fret number is 4. So we are going to count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this can also be called as box number 4. So we are here on the fret number 4. Now I tell you third string. So you will count from here, 1, 2, 3. So you are on the third string. So this is the note which I wanted you to play. Fourth fret, third string. Okay, now just try one more. Seventh fret, first string. Okay, so you will count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, seventh fret, you can see a dot also over here. Okay, so I just told first string. So you are going to play from here. This is a B note. Okay, so this is how you locate the notes on the guitar. Now, the most important thing is how to hold the pick, okay? Actually, lot of people will tell you how to hold the pick and all that, so I also learned like that. I asked many guitarists because they used to play different kind of music and they used to use different kind of guitars also. So I was very confused, like which is the correct method. But the truth is, you can just try on this method, and when you start practicing, gradually you will build your technique. You will find your own way how to hold the pick. Okay, so for now, starting, this is actually the shape of the pick. So you will hold it like this. Okay, and for support, for beginning, you know, for beginners, for just for support, you will use your last finger over here. Okay. Make sure it is not moving that much. So the elbow will be here on the guitar till here, and you will start moving your this whole portion of the hand. Okay, so one thing is that I've seen many students playing, what they do is they keep the guitar on this angle, okay, and then they start playing. So this is a wrong angle. Always keep it straight. Okay, always keep it straight, and this portion. Okay, so you know, while we play, most of the time we only see the front part of the guitar. Okay, which fingers you are holding on the front part actually. But you know, the way you hold your thumb over here and the way you bring your fingers on the guitar is also very important. Okay, so when you practice, always make sure that you have the right angle throughout, okay, throughout the practice. You should not start by like this angle, and then slowly you shift like this. This angles should not change. Throughout the practice, you should be holding the guitar at the same position, same posture. Okay. Now I told you that I'll be teaching you two important exercises that will help your fingers to get used to the guitar. Okay. So now the concept is that you have to use your four fingers. Okay. And in the beginning, it will be a bit tough because you have to just stretch your hands. I mean your fingers. So what you will do is, you will keep one finger for one fret. Okay, so here, first fret you will use your index finger like this. Okay, then your second finger for your second fret, and third finger for third fret, and fourth finger for fourth fret. So this kind, this might be a bit of you know, stretch in the beginning. Okay, and by the way, we are only playing the last string, sixth string over here. So first you have to play the first fret, second fret, third fret, fourth fret. Okay, some children, what they do is, then these three fingers are away from the guitar, they are not in the picture. Then see, they do like this, other three fingers are not there, then the fourth finger is like that. So do not play like that. All the fingers should be nearby, see. So before I am going to play, actually the fingers are already in position. Okay, so that means your finger know that it has to come on this fret. Okay, so first we'll go on the last string, 3, 4, then we'll go to the next string, same position, first fret, second fret, third fret, fourth fret, then the next string, string, then the next string. Okay, like that. So this is the exercise. This is the exercise. It sounds very easy, but it's very difficult. I mean, to stretch your fingers in the beginning, I took around 2 months to do it, fluently. So it will take some time in the beginning, but it will help you a lot. If you do it daily, 4-5 times, it will help you a lot. I promise that. Okay, so now on the right hand, you are going to just stomp it. Now, second time when you start, you are going to start from the second fret. Okay, now second, third, fourth, fifth. Like that, okay? Okay, now you are going to start from the third fret. Like that, you will continue. Now there is another way of picking. It is called alternate picking. Okay, first one is down. This is called a down pick. Now this one is up. You are pushing to the other direction. Now this is called an alternate picking. Down, up. Down, up. Now on your right hand, what you will do is, you will, I just told you that you can use this finger as a support, and then you have to hold your pick. I told you already how you have to hold your pick. This is the way. So you will play one string two times, okay? This is for your right hand. Right hand is very important. We always concentrate on our left hand, but actually right hand is very, very important. So, okay, you will just play like this. When you are playing one string, make sure that you are not picking the other string, and if you pick the other string, then it will sound like that. Okay, so make sure that you are playing only one string at a time. Okay, I am doing this just to mute the string so that the sound doesn't ring too much. Okay, if I don't use my left hand. Okay, you have to do up and down. Okay, if I'm using my finger. Two ways of playing the guitar is, one is like plucking. You will pluck like this with your fingers, also you can pluck. Okay, this is the way you can pluck. You can pluck like this, and this is called a strumming. Mostly while strumming, we are using the pick, okay? So this is called a strumming pattern, okay? This is a down strum, this is up strum, okay? So down, up, down. This is called a pattern. So the first strumming pattern which we are going to learn is down, up, okay? So down, up, down, up, down, up. So you can count it like a beat, 1, 2, 3, 4. So on the one, you will play a down, and on the second, you will play an up, okay? So down, up. Down, up, down, up. Okay, just do it on the guitar like that. Just don't hold anything on the left hand. Just keep it muted and just play, okay? Down, up, down, up. You can play a drum beat and you can play on top of it as well. Down, up. Okay, so now now we are going to learn something called as chords. Okay, chords is a combination of three or more notes together. So here we are going to learn our first chord on the guitar, which is very easy. It's called an E minor. Okay, E minor is a very common chord. It's used in most of the rock songs and metal songs. So you are going to use two fingers, which I think you can use these two fingers also, but I think you should use your middle finger, and which is the third finger, and the fourth finger, which is the ring finger. So you can just keep it here, fifth string, second fret. Okay, remember I had just told you how to locate the notes on the guitar. So fifth string, second fret, you will keep your third finger. Okay, the third finger is here. Remember that you are keeping exactly in between the box. Okay, so third finger on the fifth string, second fret. Now you can see your ring finger is also coming into the scene. So this fourth finger, that is your ring finger, you will keep on the third string. Sorry, not the third string, fourth string, second fret. Okay. Okay. So now you can strum the guitar. See, just look at my hand, how I am strumming properly. I just told you, if you can't, you know, keep your hands on position, so you can just use this small finger as a reference here. Once you are getting that flow, then you can, you know, use your hand. So I have told you, one, down, up, like that. So, okay? So first we will do it without holding any chord. So we'll do like this, down, up. Okay, when you are doing this, just feel the beat also. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Feeling the beat is very important. If you play good music, that means you are, you know, you have to feel the music as well, because eventually we are going to play it for the audience. They have to feel your music. Okay, so always keep that beat, right? Keep that beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down, up, down. So use your two fingers now, middle finger and your fourth finger on the fifth string, second fret. Okay, fourth string, second fret, both on the second fret, only fifth and fourth string. So we'll keep it like this, and we will start the strumming now. There's one very famous song called Zombie from Cranberries. Oh. So this was an E minor chord, and mind it, it's used in like lot of songs, okay? E minor. It's used in lot of songs. Now one more chord I'm going to show you, that is a major chord. It's almost like E minor, but it's a little different. Now you can use your three fingers, that is your middle finger, ring finger and your small finger. Okay, and you can use these three fingers as well. You can, instead of the small finger, you can use index finger, middle finger and fourth finger, that is your ring finger. Okay, so now this one, second fret, second string. Okay, second fret, third string. Okay, second fret, fourth string. Strum it together, it will sound like this. Okay, another finger, which I was not using the index finger, it will sound like this. There also you can practice the strumming, down, up, down, up, down, up. So eventually when we learn 4 or 5 chords, then I will look into the strumming pattern. Okay, then it will be easy for you.